This is the Tennis Nerd Rack review of the Donnay Pro One Penta 97. I was in Marbella, in Spain for a couple of weeks, and I had a few hits with the futures players and coach, Karl, Adrian from Norway. A really talented young guy with great technique, who in the heat made me feel kind of like a hippo in a swamp. So I definitely need to hit the gym and work the courts as much as possible this summer. Karl was kind enough to let me try his rackets, a Donnay Pro One Penta, which is something as rare as a flexible 16-19 string pattern with a low weight, so pretty good for customization. The stiffness rating is at 57, which is remarkable. I don't know if this is strung or unstrung. I would bet it's strung, but I'm not 100% sure. But it's either or, it's a very flexible frame, so you need to get used to that kind of feel if you're playing with stiffer rackets. I rarely see Donnay on the tennis courts these days, and I was curious about their line of rackets and their hexa-core technology, which is supposed to create increased comfort through the layers inside the frame. So it's not a hollow frame like many rackets today. It's layered with five different layers to create better performance. The rackets I tested were strung with Luxulan 4G, which is an excellent polystring at 23 and 24 kilos. This is a very control-oriented option for such a flexible racket. I could immediately feel the ball sink into the string bed with this setup. And if you're a fan of this kind of flex and arm friendliness, I think this racket could be an excellent option for you. There is also an 18-20 string pattern if you prefer a bit lower launch angle, a bit more control. But I would say that the 16-19 didn't really have any issues with launch angle or excessive spin. Yeah, so very reliable, very control oriented. The power, however, is something you need to bring on your own. For a player like Karl, who plays actively on the Futures Tour, I can really see how this racket fits his game. He has excellent technique, but if you're struggling with some of your shots, here you really need to provide your own power. But definitely a racket that could give you a boost to learn and get deeper inside your own tennis game. Might take a while to groove with it, but might also be worth it to do that journey. The specs of Karl's rackets were bumped up in weight from the 305 unstrung spec to 335 grams strung, with around 33 centimeter balance, so quite a bit of lead tape on the hoop and on the handle as well. They're not too far in specs to my own soft drives that I use currently, but the disc racket with its smaller head and thinner beam is obviously more easy to swing, so I really enjoyed that. I really felt like I could attack the ball quite easily. I was getting maybe closer to where I came from before with the 95 square inch racket, so it was pretty good spec for me personally. I had not played a sub 60 RA racket in a while, and I must say it's an acquired taste, and it takes a while to get used to that flex. But if you really like that kind of feeling, and you would like to have an open string pattern, which is rare, I think this kind of frame is hard to find, and definitely a good get if you do find it, because it's Donnay only sells their rackets, as far as I can tell, from their web shop, which is and they're US based, so for us people in Europe, we have to pay quite hefty shipping fees to get a hold of these rackets, as far as I know. If anyone has more information about how to get a hold of these rackets more easily, please comment below. So, the flexible feel of this racket is definitely not for everyone, but if you like that feeling, this is a great racket. Very reliable, very good control, flows easily through the air. It's a racket suitable for more advanced players, or players, I would say, that want to improve their tennis and don't want to get too much for free from their rackets. This is something I usually go a bit back and forth myself if I need to get some extra power and spin, or if I can provide this myself. That's something I'm sometimes hesitant about, which racket would fit me the best. There are similarities in feel of this racket to the Angel K7 Red, which I've reviewed and used before. It's an excellent racket as well. I feel the Angel K7 has a little bit more free power and a slightly bigger sweet spot, so it's definitely easier to use than this racket. But on the other hand, this racket offers a bit more control and a slightly lower launch angle. So I think those are the key differences between these two rackets, which are both very good arm-friendly rackets. So really enjoyable rackets. Definitely something, if you're into maybe the Pro Staff RF97 or the lighter Pro Staff, this could be an excellent choice to get a more arm-friendly feel. and more flex in your string bed. So definitely something you should demo. They have worldwide a demo program if you pay the shipping over at Donnay, so you can always try that before you buy. So nice stick, hope to see more of Donnay, and thanks for watching this review and for checking out Tennis Nerd. Thank you.